Hey Star Wars fans, another FLYGUY don't know figure review. Well, LEGO review to be honest. And it's this monster, the Millennium Falcon. This set came out literally 2 months ago, a month and a half ago. 7965 is the number if you haven't seen this. And it's on LEGO.com and you'll find it pretty much, if you've seen it in stores you're lucky because it's sold out everywhere I've seen it. Literally was, as I said, a couple of weeks ago, probably nearly 2 months ago now, actually, just under, came into our stores here in Australia, and it flew off the shelves. Literally, I saw one today as part of a toy run, and I haven't seen any more since. So, a pretty cool set, I have to say. We did get a Millennium Falcon several years ago, and I'll talk about that later on, but just a quick look, as usual, the minifigs in this set, always very popular. Let me zoom in and show you the details on them. We'll get a look at them. Similar Darth Vader. We've had that Darth Vader before. We get a new Han Solo with really a combination of things we've had before. Another Lego minifigures of Han Solo. A new look Skywalker, which has got some painted legs, floppy hair, and he's also coming with a blaster visor, which I'll show you. Same old Chewie we've seen lots and lots of times before, and pretty much the same Obi-Wan Kenobi we've seen before in recent sets like the Landspeeder, and a new Princess Leia. She's got a new hairdo, and that's pretty much it for the minifigures, but we'll go through and show you that. That is a quick look at the front of the box. As I said, 7965 is the number. Some of the cooler features in this, I'll try and point out, there's a lot here. Look, it wouldn't be a Lego set if it didn't have flip missiles. They appear underneath the set themselves. There's gun turrets on either side of the vehicle, up at the top and down below. Chewie and Han there playing a holo chess on the Djarik table. We also get the hidden compartment that appears, although it didn't really appear in that part, but it's the hidden smuggling compartments that we see in A New Hope when Han and the guys arrive on the Death Star. And there's Luke down the bottom with the training remote and his blast visor. So lots of cool little features and additions. It's kind of really set as if it's on the Death Star, just as they're blasting off. Obviously there's Darth and Obi fighting away. Some other features, as I mentioned, the gun turret underneath is revolvable. And you can see this section here. There's a kind of vertical piece that allows Luke and Han to sit on two kind of missile areas, and that goes in the center piece of the Falcon, and I'll show you that. And that's pretty much it. Lots of other sets there. You'll see the Sith Infiltrator, Darth Maul Sith Infiltrator. We'll have a review coming up of that. And also that Republic Frigate Fighter 7964. We'll get a review for you of that. Not picked up the Naboo, sorry, not the Naboo, the Pod Racers yet. Not quite what I'm after, but we'll see how the prices go on that. I managed to pick this one up on a very good shop in Australia here called shopforme.com.au, who are awesome, I have to say. They've managed to bridge the gap between some real rip-off prices in Australia for Lego. This was $250 in our local Target stores before they began discounting it down to around about $199, so $50 off. Still, that is nearly $70 over the US asking price, so someone somewhere is really taking the mickey. So shopforme.com.au managed to sell this, delivered for around $180, I think it was, so a much more palatable price for me, and I don't mind paying a little bit extra, but seriously, Lego, you are taking the utter P-I-S-S. But anyway, still, at $140 for the US, this is a reasonably valued set, and it's really worth that price. Not worth $200 and not worth $250, but stunning looking set. Let me just open up some parts here and I'll show you some detail first of all. As we mentioned, we've got the gun turret up at the top. You have the revolving satellite dish there on the side, all pretty basic. The whole item opens up and spills out, and it's all kind of done. Let me show you that as we spill that open. You'll see some of the minifigures and bits and pieces in between. Have to say, this was good fun building it. Not the best at building a set, because it's pretty basic and lots of grey blocks, but good fun nonetheless. So I'll take out the weapons here just because they'll fall out as I look at them. I'll give you a quick look at the figures. In fact, I should show you this one. Whoops. Let me show you this figure. So that Luke with his floppy hair. And he, very cool minifigure. First time we've ever seen that look before. And he comes with these silver chrome belt, which is nice, and that rather angry face. But if you take his hair off, and turn his head round, you've got a really cool blast visor aspect to him, and that then fits with this very cool little blast visor helmet. So there you go, one Luke Skywalker ready to do training on the Millennium Falcon. So very cool. Other minifigures we mentioned comes with the Obi-Wan, which we've seen before. Princess Leia, whoops, we showed you that briefly again. She's just got a different hairdo. She's really showing her buns this time. Not those kind of buns, boys, but those buns on her hair. It's a very cool little figure, really nice. And we'll show you Chewie and Han. So, whoops, just as usual when reviewing Lego, if you've ever done this, things tend to fall off. So I'm taking all the things that'll fall out as I try to show you and give you a look at that. So as I showed you on the box, lots of detail inside the ship. Let me zoom in a little more and you should be able to see it. There we go. So cool little things. You've got a bed area there, this kind of two twin beds. Lots of other spits on the other side. Let me move this around. This is a big ship, I have to say. That white circular piece is the training remote that we mentioned. You can just see that there. Lots of other compartments. You'll see that red element there, that little scuba diving looking piece here. Let me lift that up. Oops. If I can. That's the hidden compartment. You'll see on the other side of that, if I can manage to get it without it all coming apart, is the... Where are we? Oops. There you go. There's the ramp. Problem with that is, unfortunately, and it's the only one of the only few problems, is the ramp, the legs, I should say, are very short. So you can't really get a figure underneath. It's not as if you could stand two stormtroopers at the bottom and reenact that kind of scene. It's just a little too short. So if Lego had given us just a little bit more on those leg struts, it would have been pretty cool. And that's the other bummer of this, is sadly this looks like a hat, again. Millennium Falcon hat. And these don't retract. The landing struts don't retract at all. So, yeah. It's not such a big deal, but still, just one of those small annoying things on such an uber cool set. So let me show you around the front, and hopefully that'll all stay in one piece. Whoops. So you should see in there, there's the Dejaric table, the Hoth, the holographic Dejaric table. There's Han Solo's console. Whoops. Lots of buttons and communication panels and whatnot, and lots of small seats there for the figures. Few different storage compartments. There's one hidden away at the front in here under this. It's not going to get down too well, but you can just see it there. I guess that's for smuggling his spice or whatever he does. And loads of different small pieces, but I mean, that's really the kind of key things. There's not a great deal inside the ship. It would have been nice to get more kind of detail or even some stickers. There's very few inside it, so there's not a great deal of anything else to show you that kind of really is a feature. We did mention at the top, let me put these down and I'll show you more detail. Whoops. Some of the gun turret aspects for the vehicle. So they all fold in pretty neatly, and one other small thing about it is that you do get to see a lot of gaps, which is not a problem compared to the previous release of the Falcon, which was 2002, I believe. 2002, 2005? I can't remember, but there certainly was a massive Falcon, absolutely huge. So big that it actually took four minifigures in the cockpit, and it was the ultimate collector's edition for the Millennium Falcon. Beautiful ship, a good friend of mine had it, just stunning looking piece. The problem I had was it was just too big, there was nowhere for me to put it. Much more a technical build, and it didn't have the play features inside as you've got in here. This effectively is a playset. The ultimate collector's edition for the Falcon, this older release, had nothing inside. It was all basically technical build and a frame to hold its massive weight. So this is really the more, this is aimed at a younger audience or bigger kids like me, and just want to kind of get that Falcon vibe that you can play inside and all the features. So perfect really buy at that price and pretty reasonable. So the other one thing about it is that's really worth noting is the front cockpit, and it's pretty easy, he says. Okay, it's not that easy. It's fairly easy to get the cockpit off. There we go. and that's what we get inside. Now, it's damn tight for two figures. It does actually show you on the front of the box that Chewie and Han are sitting in there, but as you'll see, what I've had to do is that Chewie's hand's got to go round and round the back of Han there just to fit in, so maybe he's giving him a rope or something, I don't know. But you can't really get two figures in it. It's a real squeeze, which is a bit of a shame because it's shown on the front of the packaging, and yet it's really bloody hard. There's not a great deal. So it's another small downside to it, is it's just not quite wide enough. What we do get, however, is this very cool non-stickered piece. There's very few stickers in the set, actually, overall, for something this size. And that allows you to, there you go, you can pretend you're on the Falcon. That looks pretty cool, actually. But that's all one piece, no stickers, which is nice. So, again, for the size of this set, you would have expected lots of stickers, but there's only, very small amounts of them. And they're primarily for these ports here to the back and small kind of sections. So, awesome ship. If you like the Falcon, then you will love this set. It is a beautiful piece to own. It goes very well with the Death Star set. Not only in the size of it, but just as a playset, it's a really cool, cool set. Definitely recommend you pick it up if you can find it. There's a couple of little lights in the front, although they don't light up. You can see the aspect of the Falcon there. All over it. It's not the greatest build, I have to say, to put together. There's just lots and lots of great pieces, but it is good fun nonetheless as it all begins to come together. Pretty easy build. Anyone can build this, really, any age. And look, it's the Falcon, man. You've got to get the Falcon. It's just one of those things. You've got to do it. That's the back. That's the kind of light-up piece, although it doesn't light up. It's the thrust engines. I think we still have some way to go in terms of getting an absolutely awesome Millennium Falcon. The downside, as I mentioned, is the struts, the legs have been a bit of an issue. And if I hold that up there, you tend to see, maybe you can see it or not, but it tends to be the front compartments. Again, there's a fair gap between them and the rest of the ship. And they seem to be a little out of proportion and a little too small. That could have done with being just a little bit thicker in my mind. But look, it's Lego. I'm being really critical, but it's an awesome piece. It really does look like a guitar here. It's very, very cool. It's the Falcon, what can I say? Comes with, the only other figure I should have shown you was Darth Vader. Bog standard Darth Vader, if you've never seen one before. The one interesting fact, which has been seen in many sets before, is his face from Return of the Jedi at the end, where he takes off his mask. There we go, kind of Voldemort-like face. So not a lot else there to report. It comes with two pretty thick manuals to pull this all together, and that's it. I think that's all we can cover. So there's the Falcon. Hope you like it, and let us know what you think. Leave a comment below or on facebook.com/flyguy.net, and we'll be back with lots more Lego and figures and sideshow reviews coming soon. Cheers.